Hello, welcome back to Scaffold Design for Scaffolders. I'm Alejandro Garcia, and today I will solve the exercises I gave you at the end of the previous lesson. If you haven't tried them yet, please do so now and then come back to check the solutions. If you remember, buckling is the sudden deformation of a column under an axial load below the material's capacity. You also talk about Euler's buckling formula. Remember, it's equal to pi squared times the elastic modulus times the second moment of area divided by the effective length to the second. An effective length equals a buckling coefficient k times the length of the column. Now, just having a look at this graph with Euler's formula on this hatching area in orange, we have all the area that will fail due to buckling. But below this slenderness ratio of 93.9, the columns will fail by crushing. So we reach the capacity of the material. So once you reach the capacity, just it will collapse or it will crush the material. Now, for the effective length, we have the coefficient k times the length. Now, how do we get the coefficient k? And I explain that we are considering the length of the crest of a wave, or the crest of a sea wave, it is easier to remember. So, for a ping-ping connection, that's the one we consider for tube and fitting scaffold, we already have a full crest, so our coefficient is 1. If we have fix, it's 0.5. 0.7 for fixed pin, and then for fixed free, we have 2. I also show you different curves for buckling from Euler's up to today to Eurocode 3, and we will only use this one for cold form hollow sections for tubes, scaffold tubes. Now, to obtain this graph, there are several equations on TE20 and Eurocode 3, but as I said, we are not going to use them because we have already some tables on TE20 that already provide the critical axial load for different effective lengths. And as I have indicated here, two very important values to remember are for 2 meter effective length, since it will be very common to design support towers with 2 meter fully braced leaves, and also 3.2 meters, because for a 2 meter leaf scaffold tied at every alternate leaf, the effective length will be 3.2 meters. So for 2 meter, we have an axial load of 29.1 kilonewton. For 3.2, we have 13.6 kilonewton. It's important to remember that T20 requires that every scaffold component has a factor of safety equal to 1.65. Now, let's get with the exercises. Number one, calculate the critical load of a 3 meter strut with a tight for tube using Euler's formula and compare with T20's table. And that's Euler's equation. So let's put the values. critical load pi square, I will just write again pi square, 3.14 times 3.14. The elastic modulus, since I want to obtain kilonewtons, I will write it in kilonewton per meter square. So instead of 210,000 megapascals or meganewtons per meter square, it's going to be 210 times 10 to the 6, or I mean 210 million kilonewton per meter square. And the second moment of area of the type 4 tube is 13.8 centimeter to the fourth. But since we are using meters, to convert it to meter to the fourth, we have to multiply times 10 to the minus 8. So this one goes with this one. And now we divide by the effective length, K. Since it's a pin-pin connection, tube and fitting, K equals 1, and the length 3 meters. And that's 31.8 kilonewton. Now, if we check TE20, we have that they provide critical load equal to 15.2 kN. Now, as I just said, TE20 provides all these values with a factor of safety of 1.65. So, just for comparison, without the factor of safety, you get 25.1 kilonewton. Okay? Always, Euler's equation will provide a much higher value than the one obtained using TE20's equation. Let's go with the second. Number two, calculate again the critical load, but for the other three support conditions, fix-fix, fix-pin, and fix-free. Now, fix-fix, K equals 0.5. So let's put the values. As before, pi square times the elastic modulus, 210 times 10 to the 6 kilonewton per meter square. Second moment of area is 13.8 times 10 to the minus 8 meter to the fourth. And that's K, 0.5 times 3 meter to the second. And that's 127.1 kilonewtons, or 4 times what we obtain for a pin-pin connection. Now, if you calculate with T20's equations, you get a load of 42.1 kN. If we remove the factor of safety of 1.65, just to compare with Euler's value, here we have 69.5 kN. So roughly half of the load obtained with Euler's formula. Now, fixed pin. So here, K equals 0.7. So I will just repeat everything. Pi square times the elastic modulus, 210 times 10 to the 6. The second moment of area, 13.8 times 10 to the minus 8 meters to the 4. And now this is divided by the effective length, this case 0.7 times 3 meter. And that's 64.9 kN. Now on T20, you will get a value of 27.1. And without the factor of safety, it's 44.6 kN. So roughly 30% less than with Euler. And the last one. Now we have a fixed free column with k equal 2. So now we have, as before, pi square times 210 times 10 to the 6 kilonewton per meter square, 13.8 times 10 to the minus 8 meters to the 4th. And now the effective length, we have 2 times 3 meters to the 2nd. So this gives a value of 8.0 kN. Now if we check with T20's equations, we have a load of 4.3 kN. And without the factor of safety, we have 7.1 kN. Okay, well, I said using T20's equations, but you can also check the different effective lengths on the table you saw before. So that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you had all the exercises correct. If you didn't, please try again and leave comments with any questions you may have. I will be happy to answer them or even prepare an additional video if it's needed to understand better the concepts of buckling. So thanks again. Don't forget to click like below and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any future videos. Thank you very much. Bye bye.